Happy Pie Day! Every year I bake my annual Pie Day pie. I don't bake pie just to make a pie and connect it to the pun and the wordplay of Pie Day, but I really do try to be thoughtful about the pie I'm baking and the math connections I can make to it. And so you'll notice this year I made a square pie. And you may be wondering, now if I just made it a square pie, what's the connection to the number pi? And that's going to be my lesson today. So for this year's pie, you may be wondering, I baked a mango curd cheesecake pie. And so I might be blurring the lines here of what constitutes pie or cake or, but you know what? It has crust and it has a filling. And so we're going to call it the pie. So the math connection I'm going to be making today is really looking at the area of a circle. And that was something that we've all been maybe given or just told, that the area of a circle is pi r squared. And it's not often something we like think about, like what that means. Using the radius, and so that's r. We'll plug that number in, we'll type it into the calculator, it spits out a number, and we write it down, and we don't even think about like what that means. Let's think about what pi r squared means. And let's break it apart, and let's just look at the r squared part of this. If we take our circle with radius r squared means the square with sides r. My two cake tins are both 8-inch cake tins, but this 8-inch cake tin means it's 8 inches across the diameter. And this 8-inch cake tin means that it's 8 inches on one side and it's a square. So what does r squared mean? I can take this r, this is the same r, but r squared is like this, right? R squared is the area of this square. Let's just cut this out. So we could call the area of each of these squares, this is an r squared. The area of this whole square is r squared. This is an r squared, we can call this r squared. How many r squares cover this pie? 4 r squares, right? So this square cake tin of my mango pie is equal to 4 r squares. And I can show you that, right? If I just lay it on top, it's not perfect, it's not exact because it's pie after all, but it's 4 r squares. So let's go back to our area of the circle. The question at hand right now is this area of a circle should be pi r squared. It's like, what does that mean? Now we're starting to uncover pi as a number. We can model numbers on a number line. 3 is a number on the number line. 4 is a number on the number line. And then we could call this 3.5 is a number on the number line. So similarly, pi is just a number on the number line and it's a little more than 3. We know it's about, you know, 3.14159. The digits of pi never end. So the question is, how many of these r squares does it take to cover this size of circle with the radius r? And we can kind of like overlap it right here and see that it's less than 4. And so really that's my question today that I'm going to try to answer with this pie. I'm gonna see how much of this pie fits into this tin of the same width, which is, in my case, 8 inches. So it's not gonna be a perfect science, but my hypothesis, or what should happen, is that pi amount of these r squares, this size of area, should fit into this pie. So it should be a little more than 3, but less than 4. So here it goes. So I'm gonna cut this into my r squares. Oh, it's a coconut mango cheesecake pie. So here are my squares, roughly. This is very messy, as I can kind of, maybe what I should do. Oh, it smells really good. You're not gonna be able to tell, but you can see the process and trust that this is 1 r squared. Maybe I'll do this in here. There's some extra little cheesecake pie. And then I think I can cut some of this off. This is going to be,
It's tricky fitting a square into a circle. That worked out better. So this is 2r². Cheesecake is not a precise measuring tool. 3r². I haven't tried this yet. I've tried it with paper, but I haven't actually tried it with the pie yet. Where does this fit? Break it apart a little. This is 3r², so there's room for a little more. And I'm gonna just kind of guess a little bit. And it looks like it's about like that much. Just a little bit of the fourth one. So there it is. This is the visualization of how pie amount of these r² fit into this circle of area pi r². So we can see here, these r², it takes about 1, 2, 3, and a little more. How much did I take of that last one? Like this much. 3 and a little more of these r² to fit in this pi. Pi is just a number, and I think we often forget that. It's a little bit more than 3. It's further away from 4. It's in between 3 and 4. So when we think about area of a circle, you can think about this r² being your like measurement block for area. So another way we can think about this on a number line, pi being this number that we get to name. We name numbers that we use a lot, and that's why we give 3 a symbol, that's why we give 4 a symbol, that's why we have symbols for these numbers that we like use a lot in our lives. So pi, we gave it a symbol. It's just not one of our 0 through 9 symbols. We gave it this little Greek alphabet symbol for pi, but it's just a number. It's not a variable or a letter, and it's a number. And so we can model it in other ways. What happened when we say 4 of these r², what that means is it's 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 of these little r², just like we would say 3r² would be 3 of these. It's a multiplier out in front, and your r² is like your unit, your measurement cube. So if we were to say pi r², it would just mean 1, 2, 3 plus 1, 4, 1, 5, 9 of this same r². And so what I did was model pi in terms of these little like r² measuring squares. And you could extend this into other things in life besides pi. If you took one of these measurement squares, r², like you could ask how many r² is the door? This pi tin is pi r², but maybe this door is about, I don't know, maybe it's 6 across and maybe it's like 30 up. And so let's say it's about 180. No, you disagree? My camera person's making a face. How many do you think it is?
20.
20 up?
20 up.
Okay. Well, let's say it's between 20 and 30. And what did I say it costs? Like 8 across?
6.
6? Oh, I amend that answer. Let's say, let's call it 7. So what? 7 times, let's average ours, 30. So it's about 210. Of these r². So you can measure anything in terms of r². You know, it's all about measurement, it's all about what your unit is, and what, you know, you can change your r, and you can just bring new meaning to what pi r² means. It just so happens that this very special naturally occurring number pi just exists in this relationship of this r² measurement and how many of these from this square pi fit into this circular pi. So thank you for joining me on this year's Pi Day, and I hope you make some delicious pie, eat some delicious pie, and find new and interesting math connections to your pie. Thanks.